The challenge that I have since I've been a kid watching men is that men build with one hand and they tear down with the other hand. That's my only challenge to you. I don't care what you do, you grow. But what I don't like to see you do is put all this energy and effort into one thing and you build that thing up, but then you don't work on your blind spots and you tear down what you build up. I ain't tripping on no enemies or no haters. Can't nobody stop what God has for me, but I can stop what God has for me. All right, so this is why you need a coach. This is why you need people in your life, right? Because they're going to, no matter how dope you are, you have blind spots. Over 1 million people die yearly in accidents because of blind spots. Amen. I'm gonna say that one more time. I don't care how dope you are or how dope you think you are, the best vehicle, the Mercedes-Benz, the Escalade, the Ford Fusion, no matter what vehicle it is, it has a blind spot. So the reason why we teach the way we teach is because they gonna teach you to build up, but they're not gonna say nothing to you about your blind spots, and then your blind spots is gonna tear down everything you've ever built up. And so most of you, like, real, it don't matter how dope you are, you got addictions that you're not dealing with and they're gonna kill you. So you're gonna kill you. So I wanna walk you through the strategy. So first, for me, you got God in that, you got great men and women, you got the room, and you got you. And you need to leverage all four of them. That's my strategy. I've leveraged all four, right? I see people all the time who do their thing and they like, bro, I ain't into that God stuff. I'm like, bro, you don't need to be in the God stuff, but it's four in the equation. You can't take one out. Okay, so I'm gonna show y'all, for real, I'm gonna show y'all. So I was blessed, y'all. I was born in the 70s. I was blessed, bro. Like, I wasn't there for King and X and Garvey, but my people talk, like, my grandma talked about Martin Luther King like he was a god. My mom and dad will still tell you where they were when he got shot and killed. I grew up when Martin Luther King was a thing, when our people was a thing. Hip hop artists weren't the, no disrespect, but hip hop artists wasn't the people, dope dealers wasn't the people we looked up to, pimps wasn't the people we looked up to. I remember a time when Black history was, it was the real deal Holyfield. And you had to put respect. When you said Martin Luther King, my grandma had Jesus and Dr. Martin Luther King on the wall. Yeah. I'm just being real. Jesus wasn't real high and dealing with King one down there. I said, no, that ain't no man. When I heard that speech, I was like, yo, it's some God in that. There's some spirit in that. You hear all them people, you got to understand, this was a time when my grandmother, when you would say white people, my grandma would talk slow, or she would quiet, or she would kind of be timid. This was a time when my people, when you would say, sir, they like, whoa, Martin was like, he had them like, he had people who were scared, people who just saw Emmett Till get shot and killed, like people who were timid. He had people like, let's go. Yep, we can do it. Like, free at last, free at last. I said, that ain't no man. That ain't flesh. That's something else in him. That's something else that's speaking through him, that he got people from all over the world responding. That's different. I knew from that day forward, ain't no way, Eric, you're going to be able to move the crowd without having God. I take delight in the Lord, and he will give you the desires of your heart. I was like, bingo, got it. Got it. He didn't say nothing about man. He didn't say nothing about men opening the doors for you. First thing it said was, take delight in the Lord. May he give you the desires of your heart and make all your plans succeed. I've seen humans do plans that didn't work. I was like, oh, look like if God doing your plans, they're going to succeed. I'm just being real with y'all. Like I am my father's child. I come from where my people come from. But when I was about 8 years old, I fell in love with God. When I was about 16 years old and was homeless, I went in. Like, you hear people talk about lifting weights. You hear people talking about money. You hear people talk about playing football, basketball. I've been on God like that since I was 16 years old. 3 o'clock in the morning, boy, I ain't been playing with God. You look at a guy who work out and they got, like Jeremy said, they got, like, if you looked at me, like, you can't see it because it's spiritual, but I got, I got some traps humans don't normally get. I've been doing this thing since I was 16 years old. God all day, God all night. I ain't been playing with this thing. I ain't been playing with it so much, and I ain't perfect, but I'm telling you, I only been sexually active with Didi. I ain't even slept with another person because I didn't want it to mess up. I ain't never drank, I ain't never smoked, I ain't want nothing to mess this up. And I'm as human as you are. Believe that, brothers. Don't get it twisted. I got the same desires you got. But when I looked at X, what made me love Malcolm was when Malcolm got true to the game. Malcolm didn't play with the game. Nobody had no dirt on Malcolm. When Malcolm converted, he converted. And I made up in my mind when I got started in this journey, I'm going God all the way. Because I can't trust myself. And I don't want to build something up great and have it torn down. When I build this up, I want the foundation to be strong. Because if I got to rely on me, it's coming down. Because I know who my father is and my grandfather. I know. So I'm building heavy. Many of you are building up, but you're not building down. You don't have a strong foundation. You ain't strong enough for the success that you're about to get. You're not strong enough for all the power and influence you're about to get. I started this thing. My formula was God. We're going God first, nothing else. I ain't got to dribble. I ain't got to play. We just go every day. We just go 3 o'clock in the morning. And while the world may not see the significance of the three, they going to feel the significance of the three. What's your foundation? What you building on? I'm not telling you God, but whatever it is, it better be strong. Because you're going to be successful. You're going to have some, you know what killed me about cats? Cats, I can't believe. I'm like, bro, kill it. You had opportunities. You didn't steward them. Don't act like God ain't never gave you no opportunity. You've been given opportunities. You blew them. Don't make this about her. Don't make this about him. Don't make this about racism. Don't make this about your daddy and your mama. You've been given opportunities. You weren't strong enough. You weren't ready for them. You blew it.